21. Yes. Just to make sure you know where you are, we are in Baltimore, and I'm going to have this little call and response to make sure you're awake. Let me start nicely. I'm going to say, when I say I can, you're going to repeat and say be more. So let's try this. When I say I can, you say be more. I can.
Be more.
I can.
Be more.
I think I hear my students a little bit louder than this bigger audience. So let's try this again. When I say I can, you say be more. I can.
Be more.
I can.
Be more.
Good afternoon. I am Brian Gerardo, the executive director of the Baltimore Dance Crews Project.
Hello, and my name is Cynthia Chavez, and I am the executive artistic director of the Baltimore Dance Crews Project. I am so excited to be here today to see leaders serving youth from all across our nation. And in 2008, I started my first year here as a teacher in Baltimore City. And within my first 6 months of teaching, I quickly realized just how talented and special my students were in art, in music, in dance, and in athletics. But soon after that, I quickly recognized that although talent is equally distributed, unfortunately, opportunity is not.
When we talk about opportunity gap here in our state of Maryland, we're talking about Maryland ranking in the bottom 10 states in access to after-school programs. We're talking about over 270,000 students who would be in an out-of-school time program if one were made available. This April, we are nearing the anniversary of the Baltimore Uprising. And last year, many organizations were quick to recognize the need for out-of-school time programs and were quick to find funding to support after-school recreation centers as well as summer camps. But we missed a critical issue, access. Many of our students are limited in terms of income as well as transportation to access these very programs that we're getting funding. The Baltimore Dance Crews Project addresses access by bringing hip-hop dance programs directly to students and their schools. And we do that in four phases, starting all the way from simply exposing students and their teachers to the joys of hip-hop dance, all the way to our audition-based teams, which you're going to see today. But why a hip-hop dance team here at Ready by 21? How many of you have ever taken a dance class ever in your life? Yes! That is the most hands I've seen in a long time. But keep your hands up real quick. Keep your hands up real quick. How many of you have ever taken a dance class led by a youth member, someone who's young? That's what we're addressing. We're here at Ready by 21 because our four phases of programs have developed a leadership pipeline that prepares our students to be the teachers at the front of the classroom. We're preparing our students to become our teaching artists. So the students you see today, one of them is part of our pilot program who is a teaching artist who leads his own 35 students. Now imagine the same group of students, each of them teaching at a local elementary or middle school. How many more students would be in a program? And through our programs, we have already achieved this season alone, we've reached 7,500 students across the Baltimore region. Most of those, because we are inspired by our students and their leadership. But we're not done. So we're here at Ready by 21, because imagine saying to someone, we're reimagining career development by creating a program that says, hey, you want to be a hip-hop dance teacher? They have to be on time at their school. They have to learn how to lesson plan. They have to learn how to work with their teachers. They have to learn how to lead a group of students. And this is how we're reimagining how to bring these Ready by 21 21st century skills to our students.
So before I bring the students up onto the stage, how many of you have actually been to a hip-hop dance performance with a raise of hand? Awesome, awesome. Great, that's a pretty good number. So as a hip-hop dancer, hip-hop dance showcases are pretty unique. We love when people are cheering, are yelling for us. It gives us more energy and it allows definitely our students to dance even harder. One of our favorite ways of cheering, which I will show you and you can definitely use this, is called the yas clap, okay? So I'm gonna show you what that looks like. They already know what it is. So I'm gonna count to three. I'm gonna go one, two, three. You clap and then you put your hand up and you go yas, all right? So I want you to try that with me. So that in case while the students are performing, you see something that you really like, you have something to use to do to show that you appreciate what they're doing up here. So let's try the Yas clap on three. One, two, three. Yas! It's beautiful. So again, you can use this, you can use the Yas clap, you can cheer, you can clap, you can hoot and holler, you can wiggle in your chairs if you like what you see. They feed off of your energy. So today, who I'm bringing onto the stage, we have an audition-based youth team that we work with all year round. During the 2014-2015 school year, we had only one youth team serving about 25 students. This year, we had such a huge influx of students interested in the program, we got a double the amount of students interested, so then we had to split it into two youth teams. One is the BDCP junior varsity team, and then one is the BDCP senior team. So today they are doing a joint performance for you all, which they've performed in Virginia as well as in Philadelphia recently. So they are excited to share the stage with you. All right, so without further ado, I'd like to welcome the BDCP youth team.
Everything I want in my life except a girlfriend. B2K. Buy a pipe. Just copped a Bentley and it's parked in my garage. A 2 o'clock appointment for my massage. Taking pics with chicks that look like Alicia Keys. All of that, I'm still missing one thing. Oh.